Really good because you'd often have blokes. I remember Tony Shaw, the captain of Collingwood, and Tony was a big mouth on the field. Tony, shut up, do you want to umpire, do you want to play, that sort of thing. But Tony, you'd get them after the game and you'd have a few drinks and have a bit of a talk and go through, and they'd often want to talk about some things in the game. And often it humanised you, you know what I mean? So like the next time you came to umpire them, oh, Reezy, how are you? And it was a nice positive vibe there because you had that social interaction with them.
Well, that's the sign to end the second quarter. At Hawthorn in a pretty good position.
The communication is a really critical part of umpiring, and it's also a critical part of playing the game. We need to ensure that players understand our decisions, and we don't want them to stop talking to us. All we're saying is we want you to speak in the manner in which you would like us to speak to you.
Actually, when I was...
From half-back, off to Nash. Oh, gee, set him up. And that's what you call inventing a handball. Didn't need the handball.
Umpiring interstate football, as it is, over Subiaco, West Australia, they would have 6,000 school kids as the cheer squad behind the goals. On a Tuesday, they always play. And you have to be in control of your emotions, control of yourself psychologically, because the crowd can try and get
you. They're having a go again. We tip this. This will be on for young and old before it's over.
Michael and McCarthy.
Well, they're going in now.
You've got to be realistic and realise that out of the 33 AFL field umpires, only three are going to get that gig in any one year. So it is very competitive. The boys, don't worry, the boys have a bit of a crack and they're always happy at training. Like tonight is our first training session for the week, and there'll be guys that will use the warm-up as a bit of a chance to perhaps have a crack at someone who's made a decision that might have been a bit off on the weekend.
You know, there really is a good social life surrounding umpires. You know, after the game, they'll come together with the players and have drinks together. You know, after training, they'll come and, you know, they'll come and drink together. Grand final day, everyone comes together and has barbecue. You know, people who aren't umpiring during the weekend, they'll go to see their mates umpire. You know, just there is such support for umpiring at local level.
I had to do, when you first come on the list, you have to do some country games. And I had to do some country games down at Warrnambool. And there was what they call a civil war game, South Warrnambool versus Warrnambool, right? And there's like about 8,000 people, which was big for a country game. I've walked out in the boundary line to start the game. There's no players on the field. There's no one there. Big crowd around the boundary. And from the wing, this woman started abusing me. She abused me, and she gave me hell all day. I mean, it just went on and on and on. And she was clearly, he had this big booming voice, and just giving me heaps the whole day. And clearly she's barracking for South Warrnambool, and at about the 25-minute mark of the last quarter, on her wing, it's gone out of bounds right in front of her. And I've had, have it in, thanks, boundary, and I'm at the side of the pack, and she's giving it to me. She's giving me the big... And the only time I ever did this in umpiring, I just turned around and I went... And she said, "Don't you kiss me, you big white rabbit." And there would have been about 50 heads roaring with laughter around her. She would have gone home hoarse. Her team's won by about 7 or 8 goals, but she's abused the umpire, and that's all that matters.
picked up by Dunstan, got one too high, and he'll get a free kick. In fact, it could even be a little bit more than that. It's a report.
It's bordering on pathetic.
The AFL's censorship of coaches is getting under the skin of Grant Thomas.
A furor erupted when St Kilda coach Grant Thomas, seemingly overcome by frustration, incurred a $20,000 fine for these comments.
Put their ego in the locker when they start their career and pick it up when they finish their career, and players are what the game's about. I don't see too many kids running around at school with white shirts on.
Thomas was joining a melee that had started earlier in the month and just kept growing.
Freedom of speech is dead and buried when it comes to certain issues.
I sometimes think the AFL gets a bit big brother. Like, if you criticise people within the AFL, they might send you the please explain.
I think if we make them a protected species totally, it's going to actually cause a furor at the moment.
It was almost the final chapter in the controversial...
The most famous one was one that's been going since the 80s of St Kilda player Robbie Muir, who was shown a lot, was throwing his mouth guard at me, etc., after just knocking out somebody. That's a pretty famous incident, yeah.
Kevin Smith struggling to come to grips with the fiery wingman. Muir apparently thought he was hard done by and took out his frustrations in no uncertain manner.
Money. Yeah, 95%, certainly 85% to be conservative, join because of the money. Young people want pocket money because it's the world's best kept secret in terms of money. People do sometimes umpire both Saturday and Sunday, and they make heaps of a weekend at 14 years of age, no tax. It actually is money.
So I think a lot of people do see umpires as a necessary evil. But the bottom line is we need them. And I think also, having said that, with junior umpires coming along, we've got to be very supportive of them. Because my son plays for Waverley Blues, and I often see umpires, and sometimes I have to bite my lip because umpires will make really bad decisions. But you've got to realise, in the same way the boys are learning football, the umpires are learning to umpire. And you know, I could play 30 decisions in a game and get 29 of them right. The only one we talked about was the one I got wrong. And I probably was wrong. So we all make mistakes, but you've got to understand, I think if we're going to have, we need umpires to have games, and we need good umpires coming through, but we've got to make sure we support them as they come through in the same way as we support the footballer. The young kid playing footy kicks four goals, drops 10 marks, but we only talk about the four goals. We don't talk about the negatives. The umpires, we only talk about the negatives. So I think we've just got to have a positive frame of mind for any sort of official, be it basketball, football, hockey, whatever.
Gonna make it bend and break. Say a prayer, but let the good times roll. In case God doesn't show. And I want these words to make things right, but it's the wrongs that make the words come to life. But who does he think he is?